So for my next video, I'm just going to show you the process of punching out a Neolithic style quadrangular adze. So I've got a copper punch here. And what we're going to do is try and work these various angles into 90 degrees all the way around the core as best we can. So the punch is usually sat on the edge like so. The punch is a brilliant tool in the sense that it allows us to do something which is very difficult in flint mapping normally, and that is to create a 90 degree angle. But we have to work our way into the nodule to do that, so I'll show you how that's done. What the punching flakes typically are short flakes with pronounced bulbs of percussion. So they're quite thick at the top and thin at the bottom. And this is the way that we can use the punching flakes to quickly steepen up the edge of the core. So I'll keep chipping for a bit longer and then I'll show you what I mean. And what we need to do with our punch flakes is to get them to terminate just short of the base of the core so that we can then flake bidirectionally from the base of the core back up towards this platform. So we'll work our way into that slowly. One way that we can do that is to come from the side. I've just taken some flakes off along that edge there, which is the side of our original working face, and hopefully we can now punch some flakes back this way. If I can get a bit of purchase, there we go. Do the same thing at the other end and work our way back in. So I've taken off flakes on both sides there now, there and here, and that angle there is just right for punching some flakes back the other way into the base of the nodule. Now I'll start to work. So we've got our flakes coming from the top, we've got flakes coming from the side, flakes coming underneath. Now we need to make a couple of flakes on the side here that give us a 90 degree angle to flake back this way underneath the core. So a couple of carefully aimed punch flakes should do that. So that rather thick flake scar that I just took out there with the big bulb of percussion now gives me an edge angle to strike flakes under the underside of the core. Like so. That's allowed me to take a flake off from the underside of the core. And then I can use this little lip here that results from that negative removal to start to work my way along this edge. And we'll get the bite. So we just place the punch carefully on that edge. And then we have a flake scar, which removes a lot of the bidirectional flaking coming from this platform and now creates a platform to work my way along this base. And the beauty of the punch flakes is that with every deep percussion, scar, we now have platform to work back the other way. Now, I'm just going to steepen up this platform from the top a bit more. Intended to, but that's okay, it's very easily corrected. Working at lots of different angles to get these flakes to come off in the right directions. So I'm just making a series of platforms along the top here now, so that I can straighten up this bottom edge. Unlike normal flint knapping, where we flake away from ourselves, often with punching we flake towards ourselves. So we've now got one near 90 degree angle. So what we can now do is start to work our way around the other side. Come back to that shortly. So I've now got flake scars running down both sides and my 90 degree angle on this side. So we'll keep working into this core. Every time we take a series of flakes off one side, it's a perfect set of platforms for the other side. So those flakes are starting to intersect now in the middle, giving us a nice flat top to the core, which is just what we want. Now soon we'll have to start working our way into this base here. So probably I'll come take some flakes off from the side here to flatten this down. To do that, I'll have to do one of my little side flakes again, like so. Take a flake off the side there. That creates a platform for me to now punch off some flakes across the bottom. Like so. Nice big one that time. Come from the other side. Flake scars are starting to intersect on the bottom side as well now. To work my way into that a little bit more. As soon as we get a little lip on these scars here, then we can start to strike back the other way. We'll get that shortly. Okay, so now I've got a lip on the base here, which I can use to strike back flakes from the bottom. So let's get our bidirectional, second bidirectional edge going. So again, by taking off that little flake scar off the bottom there, I've now created a platform for my punch to strike off this lump with. So that lump was removed in one large punch strike from the edge. Okay, we'll keep working our way along here. Make another platform to strike off the next big lump. To do that, I think I'll make these angles a bit more right angle. So we've got plenty of mass we can play with here. It's quite a big core. Just work my way along this edge a bit. That's the next part of that big lump taken off with one big punch strike. So I'll take off the rest of that lump from the other side. For that I'll need a nice platform. Just straightening up. So now I can take off this lump here using platforms I just created on that ridge. Stick terminated that, unfortunately. It's okay, no technique is foolproof. Keep working our way in from the various sides. Strike one from the other edge now. So it's got some flakes coming off from that side now. I'll flatten it down. go up trying to get rid of this lump. There we go. So that's the lump removed now. Nice big flake that runs almost all the way across. Now what we do with punch flaking, we don't want these flakes to overshot onto this platform because then we'll lose our nice 90 degree angles. So we have to be careful to pull our punches a bit, so to speak. Okay, just keep working on straightening up. Get rid of another bit of a lump here. Another nice flakes guard that's come right across there. Flatten down that section quite nicely. I'm going to try and get rid of this section here from a platform up here now. Flake scars taken along that edge now, and then I'll use that as a platform to strike up through the middle. And hopefully we can really flatten this section down now. Got a nice long flake through the middle there. Really thinned that section down through the middle. The beauty of punching is that you can attack it from any angle. I'm by no means a master of it, but even with my limited ability in this technique, I can see the potential of it. Okay, we'll just keep narrowing the piece down so that we end up with something like an axe at the end. So we'll just bring the sides in. Try and preserve as much of the length as possible. Just make a little side platform there. Do another series along the edge. Bring the edges in more and give me platforms for pinning the base a bit more. So now I've got nice bidirectionality on that face, on the sides, two sides, the ends nice and square and thick. So we'll just keep working our way around the piece. Flattening everything down, trying to avoid step terminations. Sides. Just clamping it between the legs there as a vice. So you can see we're slowly getting our rough out of this Danish or Neolithic style quadrangular axe. Beautiful long flake there that's taken off a little bit of cortex and thinned that side down nicely. Small platforms on the edge. There's concavities that serve so nicely as a platform. And there it goes. This technique was used throughout the Neolithic parts, like places like Denmark on that beautiful Danish flint. It was used in the Pacific by Maori adze makers, Southeast Asia as well. And it can be done with antler, bone, copper, a variety of different materials used as a punch, maybe even dense shell, other stones. So many possibilities there that haven't really been explored experimentally or archaeologically yet. See if I can just take a really nice long flake off. There we go. Start to really thin down that flat surface on top there. I'm going to have to do something similar up the top here in a second. Just create a platform. Nice flake, there we go. So a nice big flake through the center there that really thins top down. Now if I can just get one through here, maybe from both sides, we should have a nice flat top on the surface. There we go. Right through the middle, so that's now a very flat topped rough out for our small Neolithic style quadrangular axe. Keep working on this now, bring the edges in a bit more. Just do this on top and bottom, trying not to knock any platform edges off. See here, he's got a slight overshot here. This is what we're trying to avoid, is when the flakes run over the edge a little bit and they remove what was a flat surface, and that can damage the edge angles and remove the concavities that we're always trying to create. Another nice flattening flake through the middle there. Easier to flatten this down finally once we get the edges quite close together. Flakes won't have to travel so far. Edges closer. Just lots of little short flakes from the sides, being careful not to overshoot. Oh, overshot there. Very easy just to tap it a tiny bit too hard. okay. Very easy to fix still. I've got plenty of raw material. We've got a very nice flat top to our axe now. This side still has a few little lumps to remove, so I'll get on with finishing those off. That'll help. Nice long flake through the middle there. The beauty of this technique is once you've got an edge set up, you can just work your way along it very quickly. Getting closer to our final form now. Punched out on all sides. Need to flatten the top a bit wherever the platforms allow. Getting a nice flat top now. Punch technique is also a mainstay of some of the formations, particularly of the handle on the Danish daggers, which I may do a video on soon. Close to our final form now. wee step I need to put there. It in from the side. Important things not to rush. Just to take it slow. Work out the piece step by step. Start bringing down the front a bit now. Ready for the blade. Put the blade on the piece. For that, I'm just going to take some longer flake scars down the front. Get a nice long one down the front now. That's a good one. Let's run all the way down through the middle there. Okay. Let's try and finish this baby off now. Important not to over punch any spot, but to make sure you've got platforms so you keep coming back to it, making sure everything's set up just right before you attempt it. So our piece is looking, getting very much the appearance of an axe now. And I'll just start to put the blade on the front here now. So a couple of long tranchet-like flakes down the front there. Very quickly bring down the front of the axe. Two of those in a row. You can do that on both sides, and then we'll punch the edge itself. So brought that front down almost to a sharp edge angle now, so it's time to just punch that, the remaining parts of that. So I don't want to lose too much more length off the front. On there, so thin down this edge a bit. That's good. Technique's definitely best done on high quality raw material, so that little taps will take flakes off rather than hard hits that can overshoot and do irreparable damage. Lost all of our platforms on this edge, so I just need to tidy it up a bit. It's not a fast process, but it is a precise one. Series of little new platforms along this edge, bringing the edges in just a tiny bit more, and if you think the process of flaking takes a long time, the grinding of something like this would be an enormous task. It takes many hours just to put a little bit of an edge on one of these, which is why many of them were never fully ground, although they were extensively ground, which allows us to see the manufacturing marks, which is a nice thing. Angling this right out because we're quite thin now, so we don't want to overshot by taking off very long flakes. Okay, so we now have the outline of our axe pretty well sorted out. Bidirectional flaking on all surfaces, platforms everywhere. And now we can probably just finish off the butt up here and the blade. And then it would be time to move on to maybe a bit of grinding. Okay, so the butt now, we'll just do some little short bidirectional flakes along this edge. Just remember that we've got to keep our platforms going, don't just bash it willy-nilly. Very small hits along the base there. And I'll do the same from the bottom. A lot of these aren't coming off because I'm just trying to be very gentle with it. Need to make a new platform. Straighten down this last bit of edge. Don't want to take off too much anywhere. That's the back of the axe all finished. Like so it's all nicely squared up now. Nice uniform thickness. Now for the blade itself. There's probably just one more little flake scarf to take off in here. Don't have a good platform for it on that side. I think I'll just leave it, it's not a problem. Okay, now the blade. Okay, so for the blade, we're just going to do alternating flake scars along the edge. Being careful not to start right at the edge here. Okay, so we're starting to get our flake scars appearing on the edge now, making a blade. We're nearly done there. That's the front sharp edge of our axe now. And now we'll take some going back the other way. So we have a nice bifacial edge. It's uniformly thin and ready for grinding. Okay, so that's the axe finished. It's not a particularly large one, but nevertheless shows you the process, the way an axe can be made from a nodule of flint using a punch and not a single freehand percussion blow on the piece. So I hope you find that useful. Maybe you'd like to give it a go at home yourself. Doesn't take much in the way of tools, just a bit of nice flint, a little copper rod like this. Doesn't even need to be sharp. And you can grind it down to a little bit of a rounded or sharp tip if you like. A sharper tip will give you a finer flake scars. But it's not necessary to have a sharp tip. And certainly for some of the bigger removals, a bit of a blunter blade is actually quite useful. I'll just do some final tidying up at this edge. Like anything, you can continue to do this internally and then end up with a piece that's only a centimetre long. So at some point, we have to say enough's enough. I think I've reached that point now. So that's my little Danish style axe, quadrangular, flaked on all sides, and ready for grinding. Thanks for watching.